Today I want to introduce you to 5 business information technology jobs which will pay over $100,000 in a year. Before we start, I want to show you something. Come a little bit closer, just slowly but steady, a little bit closer to me, because here you're gonna see the subscriber account is slowly but steady growing up. So I just want to say to everybody, thank you very much, Dankeschön. And if you haven't already subscribed, I highly recommend you to do it right now. Yalla. I would like to introduce you to the first working field, and I have 3 questions for you. The first question is, do you like software development? And if the answer is yes, then the second answer is, do you also have the interest to be a system administrator? And the third and the most interesting answer for you, of course, is, do you want to earn $120,000 by doing so? Then you should definitely start your career as the so-called DevOps engineer. So what is exactly a DevOps engineer? A DevOps engineer is someone who plays a major role in software development inside a company, but also this person is responsible for the system administration. So your future work would be to develop, for example, scripts and tools, and also to execute the needed performance tests to see if those software you have created is actually working or not. So as a DevOps engineer, you have to be an all-round talent. You need the right knowledge in software development, you need also the right knowledge in database development, but also you have some kind of knowledge in cybersecurity if requested. And the mid-salary is rewarded for this kind of profession with around $120,000 in a year, and I think it's a good start to go, right? I'm also a programmer by myself, and of course most of the programmers are shy people that don't want to have much interactions with other people, but luckily we have the fantastic technology we can use to act, or let's say to appear somehow normally, and that is the reason why people like me, we need apps like Tinder, for example, to communicate with the outside world. And that is the reason why, thankfully, the app development market is booming. And this is the reason why the mobile application developer is ranked as the second highest income you can achieve with $135,000 in the year. And because the app market is right now booming, that is the reason why, for example, in comparison to a software developer, usually a mobile application developer or app developer can earn more money than the classical programmer in software development. So sometimes people ask me, Ruslan, is the studies in business information technology really worth it? And I think the best answer to give to this question is to make a good example what actual information systems are. So we use our mobile phone when we go to work, we use our PC during the work. When we go back home, we want to watch maybe Netflix or whatever, we use television. So everything we use in our daily life, which we can call as technology to make us feel comfortable, to make us feel relaxing, is somehow directly related with information systems. And when we use those information systems, we create a lot of data, and this data has to be somewhere storaged. And that is the reason why the third profession could be might interesting for you if you're interested in databases. And the third profession is called big data engineer. So what is actually a big data engineer doing? A big data engineer can help companies to create those infrastructure to storage those big data. If you have the interest into databases, and I also think, from my personal opinion, databases is a really interesting work to do, then you should definitely take a close look to start your career properly as a big data engineer, which will be rewarded with the amazingly $130,000 in a year. When I say the word construction architect, you will probably imagine what kind of work this person is probably doing. So when I ask you what is actually an application architect, you will probably have a few problems, but that is totally fine. That's why I'm here. So I'm gonna tell you that usually if you want to try to build a house, you use some kind of a roadmap how you should use the house. How many stages does this house has, how big has every room has to be, or whatever kind of infrastructure we need to create inside the building to build this house. And this is also the same way if you as a business owner, for example, has the interest to optimize your business, to digitalize your business. And this is the reason why you also would hire a so-called application architect, which will help you to create the right roadmap. So you're gonna know what kind of technology do I need, what kind of processes are those technologies are making, and how those technologies are interacting with each other, and what kind of budget do we need, what kind of technology do we need, what kind of people do we hire, whatever. So in the same way we can imagine what a construction architect is, the same way we also have to imagine what an application architect is actually doing inside the business when it comes into the world of technology. You need to have like a huge resistance towards pressure, but also you need like the work experience, because this is of course a job with a lot of responsibility, but this job is amazingly rewarded with a mid salary of $150,000. Nice. And the first place goes to, drum please, to the so-called information security manager. Very good, fantastico. Like I said before, as an individual, we use in our daily life information systems, and that is the reason why we also create a lot of data. And this data, like I also said before, has to be stored somewhere, but it is not enough to storage those data. We have also to make sure that those data has to be encrypted. But what is actually an information security manager is doing? You of course have to manage a bunch of people in your cybersecurity team. You have to make sure that you keep a big eye on the given budget, that you hire the right educated people, that you also do cybersecurity tests and reviews inside the company, and much, much more. So it can be like a huge list, but you have to understand that as an information security manager, you are usually the top number one guy or girl inside the company who has the knowledge when it comes to the right questions about cybersecurity. So this amazing job is rewarded with on the mid salary level of fantastico $150,000 in a year, which is amazing, I think, right? Dankeschön for watching this video. We're gonna see you in the next one. Peace.